In this one, I'm going to talk about error handling in C and how there is basically no language construct for it. It's just by value. So often, I mean, you probably already know this. If a function has an error inside of it, the way it indicates that to you is that its return value is going to change often. And the way it's done is if the function returns a pointer, so in this case, I'm trying to open a file and file is a pointer. If there is an error, f will be the pointer f will be null, and often on other functions, like for example, let's say the read syscall, it returns minus one. Often minus one is the error. Yeah, exactly. On error, minus one is returned. So after every function call that could have an error, you need to check the return value often to check if there was an error. And the simple way to do this is, for example, to import assert. And here you could do if f is equal to null, do something. But a much simpler way if you're prototyping or do not care too much, but still want to catch the error, is to assert this way. So for now, you can see that I'm opening the current file, which is t.c, and just outputting it. So let's compile this. Need to different than null. We need to assert that if it doesn't work. So as you can see, this works for some file. And if I put like some random garbage here, so a file that doesn't exist, you will see that we have an assertion error. Unfortunately, I mean, that's great that we already know that there is an error and we know at which place, and we can kind of know, like, at least we know that there is an error. But we don't know what was the error about, because the fopen could have failed for multiple reasons, like because the file doesn't exist, or there is no permissions, or there is no more memory on your system, or stuff like this. And this is where erno comes in. So if you don't know, C has a global variable called erno, which you can import with which you can import with by including the erno.h header, and this header contains the erno global, and this global variable will be set to a specific value according to the error that happened. So here, let's say if f is equal to null, we're gonna do printf d like so, r no, and it's just an int. So let's return one. So if we do that, you can see that r no was set to the value of 2. So that doesn't tell you much, but yeah, and I need to show you that if the call succeeds, r no is actually equal to 0. So if and you have to set it before, r no is equal to 0, like so. So as you can see, erno is zero when there is no error. And so yeah, you saw that it's we put random garbage back. So it's an int if it failed, but you don't really know what does that mean. And so erno has multiple global constants for to check what it is. And those all start with E something, and I don't know the name by heart. The names of it, I think, erno list. Yeah, as you can see, there is a bunch of variables like so. And there is a function called str error, which, or first p error, which will print the error message associated with that erno ID. So maybe that sounds a bit weird, but if you do p error and just give it null because we don't care for now, and you execute this, you can see that it interpreted the global erno and gave you a human readable message, which is no such file or directory. But here you can see that I have a foo file with permission set to zero everywhere, so you cannot open it. And if I try to open a foo this time, so it exists, but no permissions. As you can see, the error code has changed, and this time permission denied. So the human readable message has changed as well. And the first argument of p error is just a string to prefix it. So if you want to do hello, like so. It would just prefix the printing by some something, which can be useful. But yeah, that's how you would generally handle error in the C standard library. I should specify that there is in addition to the p error function, there is str error, and you give it erno, and it will I need to, this one is in a string, I think, yes. So, and this will give you the same message, but this time it will give you a string to int instead of printing it directly. And so that, those are the methods you need to use to get what error happened. That's pretty much it. How you handle error in the standard library of C, at least. And I can show you a quick example. So this is one of my project where I rewrite the unique command in C. And as you can see, I use str to l, which will convert a string to a long int. And this function will have an erno value different than zero if there was an error. And as you can see, I set erno to zero because it could have been set to some random value earlier. So you need to set it back to zero before you call the function. Then I assert if it's different than zero, so there is an error, and then I call fatal. And what the fatal function does is just printing an error message and exiting the program. So as you can see, that's how you would, and it uses str error as well. That's how you would use it in a normal context, I guess. And I should specify that erno is, as far as I know, very specific to the standard library of C. So if you're using another library, it may very well be that there is another global variable than erno to set errors. I know that SDL has something different. I know that OpenGL has something different. And all of those libraries have a little bit of a different error handling scheme. But and that you have to learn on your own, because I cannot put them all in this video. But generally, it's with a global variable or return values. So that's pretty much it, and I hope it helped you be more sane when encountering some error in C. So see you.